Welcome back. Today I'm going to do a first impression video on the L'Oreal True Match Foundation. I've been wanting to try this for a little while, so I figured I would go ahead and just film a first impression so we can see together what it looks like as it applies and see how it wears. So I'm going to go ahead and apply it on my face, tell you what my thoughts are as I'm applying it, and then I'm going to check in throughout the day and show you how it's holding up. Now this foundation comes in 33 shades, which is awesome for drugstore. It comes in cool, neutral, and warm. I got the color Warm 3. This is nude beige, and it also has SPF 17, and it's oil free. But one thing that I don't like off the bat is the packaging. I wish that it came with a pump. I feel like most foundations nowadays come with a pump. Their new Lumi foundation, which I like, comes with a pump, and it's just a lot more sanitary and you don't waste as much product. But I've heard great things about this, so let's go ahead and apply it. To apply the foundation, I'm going to use my Sigma F80 flat top kabuki brush. So I'm just going to put it on the back of my hand and stipple it on my face. So pouring it on my hand, it's pretty liquidy. Like you can see, it's kind of dripping down my hand. So let's go ahead and start putting it on. It feels really light. There's not really a fragrance to it. It doesn't smell like anything. I think this color works really good too. I don't know how it's picking up in the lighting, but it seems to match really well. And the coverage is pretty good. I only applied a little bit on this side, and it seems to cover really well because I have some like little spots right here from like where I was breaking out, and it seemed to cover it pretty good. I feel like it's a good medium just with a little bit, which is awesome. And it doesn't feel sticky or anything. It feels like your skin. Sometimes before foundations set, I feel like they can feel a little bit sticky. So this is what the first layer looks like. I'm really happy with the way one layer looks. I think it looks like your natural skin, but better. And the finish is beautiful. It's a nice matte with a little bit of satin finish. It's not completely flat. You still have a little bit of normality in your face. You have a little bit of that kind of glow, but it's not dewy or anything. It's more matte, and it feels really dry. Like, it doesn't feel sticky at all. And I think it blended super easy and really nice. So I'm going to add just a little bit more to see how it builds up, just to like the center of my face where I think I need a little bit more coverage. So this is what it looks like when I added a little bit more. I think I actually added a little bit too much. I barely put any, but it's very, very pigmented, and it gives you a lot of coverage. Like, I would consider this almost full coverage, if not full coverage. I mean, it looks awesome. It looks like your skin. It dried really quick. It's a little bit sticky now that I put a little bit more. Like, you can feel that there's foundation on your face, but I think if I let it set for a little bit or a few minutes, that it'll be fine. But, I mean, I think it looks really awesome. The color match is really good. I wasn't sure if that was going to be the right one, even though I got to swatch it on my hand, because you're supposed to swatch it on your cheek or your chin whenever you're swatching and trying to color match, but there weren't any mirrors around, so I just put it on my hand and kind of guessed. But I think it looks really good, and I put a little bit under my eyes, and I don't even really think I need any concealer, and it looks flawless. I don't know how it's picking up on the camera, but I think it looks really, really good. But I'm going to go ahead and finish my makeup. I'm just going to put some blush, mascara, and some bronzer on, and then I'll come back. So I went ahead and finished my makeup. I just put on a little bit of bronzer, blush, mascara, and lip balm. I didn't put any powder on it, and I always powder my T-zone after I put my foundation on and set it, but I did not set it whatsoever, and it still feels really matte. Like, usually I can feel where it's getting a little bit oily after I apply my foundation if I don't set it, but it feels really matte, so I'm hoping for the best. We're gonna see how it wears. I'm gonna go run some errands, and I'll check back in. So right now it is 4:03. Thumbs up if you like Gossip Girl. This is, if you watch Gossip Girl, my wallpaper is Chuck and Blair, and it says keep calm and love Chuck and Blair, and it's when they got married on the season finale. But sorry, I love Gossip Girl. It's my favorite show. So right now it's 4:03. I'm going to check back in a few hours, and we'll see how the foundation looks. So it is now 7:16. I've had this foundation on for a little over 3 hours and it looks awesome. I'm still very matte, no oil whatsoever, and my blush still looks really good, like it's staying on. So you know that if your blush stays on, then your foundation is working really well because that's the base before, and I'm not wearing a long wearing blush. It's just a normal blush. So I will check back in about 3 more hours, but so far, so good. Hey you guys, so now it is 11:33. So I've had this foundation on for almost 8 hours, no primer, no powder, and I think it looks flawless and amazing. I'm so impressed. And I ran out and ran errands. I've been running around my apartment like a mad woman, and it's raining and nasty outside, so I haven't just been sitting down watching TV like I've been doing stuff. And I think it looks awesome. My blush is still on, and it looks so good, and I'm so impressed, and I'm still matte. So I'm really impressed with this foundation. I think I'm going to love it. I didn't think it was gonna look this good, wear this good, and mattify my face as well. For some reason, I always had it in my head that the L'Oreal True Match was like more for dry skin. I didn't know it was so good at mattifying. Like, it looks amazing. So overall, I highly recommend this foundation. I think it's gonna be great for the summer coming up since it mattifies so well, and it just looks awesome and flawless, and I just love it. I can't wait to see what it does when I use a primer and when I set it with a powder. So I hope this first impression was helpful for you guys. Let me know if you've tried out this foundation and what your thoughts are on it, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know in the comments what you want me to review next, and I'll see you later. Bye!